You can see the high-rise buildings, all the flyover and the metro coming here. This is in Whitefield. I'm going to explore the Anglo-Indian heritage. There used to be in Whitefield an Anglo-Indian community for centuries, but then they just disappeared as the IT industry came in. So I'm going to explore any remnants of the Anglo-Indian people, the community, and then any buildings which is there now. Just see how my luck works. Opposite to the busy street in Whitefield, I found this location. I don't know if I asked for the whereabouts of Anglo-Indian community or the association, and I didn't find any luck. So I just thought, why not? I came this far, at least get into this place and walk for a bit. I don't know what this place is. I didn't find anyone guarding it, so that means we got to enter. Oh my god, I don't know why they have left this place alone. They could have just even constructed something in this. It goes all the way. I don't know, maybe 2-3 kilometers, I don't know where it goes. Mainly I was looking for the Settlers Association, Whitefield Settlers Association. It goes like this. Wait a minute, I'll just put the mask. Whitefield was this Mysore Maharaja granted 4,000 acres of land, and Mr. White created a community sort of area for farming and people to reside. So at least for I think 2 centuries, the Anglo-Indians, I mean Anglo-Indians are those who have both Indian and British origin. So kind of they have both parental origins. So I don't think even a single house exists today, Anglo-Indian style house. Maybe if I can find someone on the internet who can say the whereabouts of someone who can give a little more insight. But then I didn't find anything more than IT companies, shops, shopping malls, all the restaurants. So I think clearly the community got buried under this development, all this development. I don't know what this place is. I'm just trespassing as if it's my own home, which is okay. I found someone, someone standing a kilometer away, but then by the time they stopped recording, I would have stopped myself. But then I took a lot of efforts to find what this place is. You can see the, I won't go nearby, but you can see the snake house or whatever it is called. Usually it is built by ants and then the snake comes in and I think and the rest is history. I can hear the noise of a train honking somewhere far away. Not far away, but okay. But I don't know where it is. I find two paths. I don't know. I'll just. Oh my god. See the size of this. You really don't want to mess up with the snake, isn't it? But then I won't. Get into the wilderness, but someone has tied this from here to there. Okay, for whatever reason. No, I find another path, but it's wet all the way, and I don't want to spoil my shoes. No, I need to walk. There were a few birds making noise, and then after hearing me vlogging, they thought. This guy sings better. We'll stop. Oh, is it a snake? My god. If it is a snake, bye bye. Have a nice weekend. I really want to walk to the end of this road and see what it is. So, since I didn't find what I came looking for, might as well explore this place. Why not? Not every day I'm going to come here and walk around this place. So finally I'm going to get a clue of what this place is before somebody stops me and say, okay, there's a house. There's a house. It's a disused house. I think so. You can say disused house by this. You can just see the tracks. No one has entered here for a while. That also means that. Okay, what is this? Okay. Vana Vigyana Kendra. Joint venture of Institute of Wood Science and Technology, Bangalore. Okay, it belongs to the forest department. And then I need to be careful with the steps. Because see, you can see the steps. Okay, there is a house. Okay, it's full of leaves now. So it gets even more trickier here. You don't want to get bit by snakes. And then see this place. I don't know if anyone stays here, but I'll just make some noise so that in case if there are some snakes, I might run away. No, what is this place? Okay, snakes, go away. It's me coming. What is this house? Okay, oops, mosquitoes, lot of mosquitoes. I found 10 mosquitoes sitting on my left hand. Okay. Okay. It looks like there are carts. People can. I don't know. I don't know what it is used for. There's one more building on the other side. But. If this is not used, we might as well think that that is not used as well. Okay, this is the way out. My God, noise is me. Oh, one mosquito on my camera. Go away. At least I got good number of mosquito bites. Okay, too many mosquitoes here. There's a building behind me, but then I thought I don't know if I need to get permission to all the way till the end, but then I got a view of how the place looks. You can also feel the place. I'll hold it far and speak louder. I think I can shout here and no one would care. Oh, there is a reason why I'm rotating the camera. It's the mosquitoes holding onto my hand. I don't want to stop recording, so it's a tug of war. I think I'll finally win. So the only one place which has some sanity here is this place. Because okay, but that's the house. That's the house, spooky house. Okay, that's the word I was looking for. Spooky, spooky house, Transylvania. I might as well pull it up if possible. Okay, it's better. Since it was raining for the last 2 days, it is very wet here. By wet I mean you can easily feel the moisture in the air, particularly in this type of forest area. It's easy to feel. Okay. We don't want to take a selfie near the snake's home. Okay. I think those mosquitoes, they thought this is the first guy coming here after a long time. And see the size of this animal. So they thought we got a customer. Okay, all guys, hold on to him for the next 10 minutes. Because these mosquitoes were from the spooky. Spooky house. One thing about these places is like the least harm someone can do is a human, because this is a forest and any human here is an isolated person. So we really don't have to fear humans here, just other other animals. Okay, I'll just show you a view of this snake house. Okay, mosquitoes again. One thing that usually doesn't get recorded in camera is the sounds of insects. You hear a lot of noises, but then those things are far away to get recorded. But okay, since I said, you can imagine. There is no light in this road. As far as I can see, there are a few lamps. I don't know if they get lit during the night. I wonder how this place is at the night. But then just outside this wilderness, you find all the laptops and the desktops flying. Booming IT industry. So this road almost made me forget about the Anglo-Indians and start searching for some more forest areas. So that's just outside the forest area. I found this. I think there's a factory here, locomotive factory. It's a train. I'm already very tired, and I think I'll be signing off for the day. Thanks for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe.